waiting to get off the grid there. You can see that the swappy cars are
the
Japanese people all over the shop.
Make any difference.
Stops on Lino. A very, very usually very, very slightly took the hand in the rest of the car. Is it good enough for that road? No, it doesn't look good. Tremendous skill he's going to get this car out. This is the man that qualified in the top 10 of the world. He was in the top 10 of the world over in Holland last week. And of course, this is touring cars. World dominating, you could say, touring cars across the globe. And great to see a couple of British drivers there. Andy Moore with Chris Granger here today with that one touring car
coming
over the start-finish line.
To be fair,
the top 10 of the world again. So James Hart with his very
side of the episode.
He's going around with a lot of skill, a lot of finesse, just stroking it round, not too much power. Of course, you've got the back end coming out because the front of the wire gets I think he's going to be on the drive car with wet weather tyres on. He has done that.
I mean, I'm not steering at the moment, my car.
So James Hart, Chris Wayne with James Hart, Phil Chambers with the X-ray up there in the third position to make it to the grid. I think that's Mr. Patrick Car 3 pulling out.
I'm not worried about me, to be honest with you.
With the rain coming down heavy. As the rain comes out and the track gets wetter, hopefully the grip will pick up for these cars on the wet weather tyres. That's generally what happens. Silver medal in this 10.5A final on the clock, which is about 3.5 hours to go. That's certainly what it seems like when you're down the driver's lap with no coat on or whatever.
So this is the 800
metre
freestyle.
Colin,
how much would you sell your jacket for?
The power, if you've got too much of the other, it's going to be off. The scenery and the markings are not doing too much at the moment. Maybe the skill of these drivers is keeping the cars planted on the track. So just under 2 minutes to go, drivers. Chris Granger with the track has just gone over the line. And look at this, James Hart is catching him. Are we going to see a bit of a roller coaster finish to this? James Hart just coming through the middle of the track. Didn't want to start pushing too much, but the solid white coloured car, which is just coming over the lines now, car number one, Chris Granger in the lead. There goes James Hart, who's actually in second position, sliding very wide at the apex of the first corner. You can see, maybe you can see the rear bumper there of Chris Granger's car. Chris is just coming through the chicane over the straight there, lapping some slower cars. And if he gets caught up in the middle of these slower cars, with 1 minute 19 seconds to go, we could probably see a different outcome to the A final. Chris Granger, best 2 out of 4 to counting qualifying. Pole position, sliding through the couple of these three cars just coming over on here. The race leader, white car with the black wing on the back.
Currently in the tank.
Body shell or body underneath it, a chassis you could say. Car number 4 pulls into the pits. Enough for Chris's Kurzweil. He's just pulled out as Bill Chambers now with his X-ray holding down that third position. I think James Hart has decided to not to push too much more. Don't want to get too much water into that car. 36 seconds to go, drivers. There's going to be a mad flurry of gazebo going down now at Snetterton. Probably faster than these cars are going around the track at the moment, but it does look like this Ranger. A very comfortable lead on Jimmy Hart there in second position. 2.5 seconds is the gap between first and second position on the track. It looks a little bit bigger than that, but 13 seconds a lap in the 12 seconds a lap for the 10.5. We're now on about 17.5 seconds a lap. That's the distance between the wet and the dry. It's solid wet with these it's a different setup with the cars at half and half at the moment. half a mark, so Chris Granger about to take the win in the BTCC. That was a very nice thing to do. That great turn right at the end just to give us a little bit of surprise. So it's Chris Granger from James Hartfield Chambers, Elliot Harper, set by the qualifying order. So we're